This lesson, we will continue with our lesson on conical pendulum. We will see two worked examples which will help us understand the concept of conical pendulum better. That said, let's get into class. Our first question says that a stone moves through an angle equal to 1.5 times 2 pi radians in 3 seconds. Find the angular velocity. And we have a snippet here that says a complete revolution is the same thing as 360 degrees. It's 360 degrees or 2 pi radians. Now, that is, the stone is going to move through a complete revolution 1.5 times 2 pi radian. One complete revolution is 2 pi radian, and the stone has moved through it 1.5 times, and it does it in 20 seconds. Our angular velocity, obviously, is equal to theta, that's the angular displacement over time. So that W, which is the angular velocity, is the same thing as our angular displacement will be 1.5 times 2 pi radians over 3 seconds. So it's equals to 2.5 times 2, 1.5 times 2, that's 3 pi radian over 3. 3 here is 1, 3 here is 1, that's pi radian. So the velocity of the angular velocity is pi radians per seconds, 1 pi radian per seconds. So this is a simple example, just a basic example to help us understand the concept. Let's see the second example. For my second example, the second example says a 1 kg stone attached to one end of a 100 cm length of string is wheeled in an horizontal circle. Now this is my string, and the 1 kg stone is wheeled around this horizontal circle. Now this is the string, sorry, permit my diagram. Or let me draw it again. This is my string. It's now wheeled around this way. So this is a stone. Now if this is a stone and this string is how many centimeters? 100 centimeters. Now the horizontal circle, this horizontal circle has a radius of 40 centimeters. And definitely here is the vertical component from the tension of the string. Now the weight of the body, the weight of the pendulum is going to be mg. If you remember from our last lesson, the weight is mg, and mg is mass times acceleration, that is mass times gravitational acceleration. That's 1 kg times 10, which is equal to 10. Now if I have 10 newtons here as the total force from the pendulum, then I can resolve this force into both. Okay, sorry. I'm going to resolve the tension in the string. The tension in the string can resolve into both X and the Y component. Now, the Y component of this string, if you remember from our last example, from our last lesson, is equal to mg. Now, the Y component of this string, that is Ty, I can resolve it to both Ty and Tx. Here also is the same Ty. Now my Ty here is equals to mg. And my Ty, here there's a theta here. My Ty is equals to T, which is the tension in the string, cos theta, is equals to mg. So that T is equals to mg over cos theta. So that T now the first thing we should be looking for is the cos of theta. Now first, what is theta? Here I have this to be 100 centimeters and I have the radius to be 40 centimeters. So that sine theta, which is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, will be the same thing as 40 over 100. Sine theta is equal to 0.4. Now theta is equal to the arcsine of 0.4. So that theta is equal to the sine inverse of 0.4. So that theta now is equal to sine inverse of 0.4 for my calculator is the same thing as 23.57 degrees. So the tension in the string is equal to mg, which is equal to 10 newtons over cos theta, that's the cos of 23.578. So that T, which is the tension in the string, is equal to 10 over the cos of 23.58 equals 0.9165. Now let's divide 10 now divided by 0.9165 is equals to, that's finally the tension in the string is equals to 10.91 newtons. With these two examples, I believe you have basic introduction into how to solve questions relating to conical pendulum. Thank you for staying with us, and please do not forget to subscribe to our channel, and see you in our next lesson.